now 31, let's see if we can graph this exponential function and state its domain range and end behavior. So if we take a look at this one, I've got an exponential function because my variable is up in the exponent. If you remember from example 3, we had graphed 2 to the x minus 1, right? And then before that, we had even graphed 2 to the x. So we've been progressing through these different types of exponential functions. So we remember from example 2 to 3, I shifted 1 unit right. I'm still going to do that. And now we have this plus 3 out here. All right, and when you're adding or subtracting a number and it's outside those grouping symbols, again, that binomial has a grouping symbol, but when it's outside the grouping symbols, it'll either move you up and down. So this is going to shift us 3 units up, where this minus 1 here was going to shift us 1 unit to the right. And again, that's 1 unit right and 3 units up from this original function of 2 to the x. If we're talking about example 3 to 4, we're just taking what we had in example 3 and shifting it up 3 units. So let's go ahead, start to graph this. Now again, if you want to make your t-table, if you want to just do a little x, y, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, and get some y values, go for it. I'm going to use technology, and I want to show you how I'm going to do this. I'm going to do it two ways, all right? So I want you to, I want you to remember we had 2 to the x minus 1 in here. That was the last example we did. Now the change from example 3 to example 4 is that I'm adding this 3 here. So I need to shift all of my y values up by 3. So what that means is I can take this ordered pair 1, 1, and I can add 3 to this y value. So I could make this the ordered pair 1, 4. Okay. So I had 2, 2 here. I'm going to shift it up 3 units. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. It's going to become 2, 5. I had 3, 4. So let me go to 3, 4. I'm going to shift it up 3 units. 1, 2, 3 to 3, 7. All right, let's see. We got 0, 1 half. I'm going to shift it up 3 units. 1, 2, 3 to 0, 3 and a half. I had negative 1.25. I'm going to shift it up 3 units. 1, 2, 3. Right, so I'm just going to shift everything up 3 units, and I can start to see the exponential growth here. And if you don't want to do that because you're like, hey, I didn't have y equaling 2 to the x minus 1 in my calculator, no sweat. Just enter the entire function, your current entire function, into your calculator and go to your table, and everything's been shifted up 3 units. You heard me just saying 3.5, 4, 5, and 7. Well, here they are. Now, I think you can see that there's a new boundary line. In all of our previous examples, our horizontal asymptote was y equals 0. Well, we're shifting this function up 3 units. It's also going to shift the horizontal asymptote up 3 units. So whereas before my horizontal asymptote was y equaling 0, I think you can see now my horizontal asymptote is going to be y equaling 3. And if I kind of scroll back here, you can see my y value is getting closer and closer and closer to 3. Now it looks like they touch 3 here. They technically don't. It's just that the decimal is so small, your calculator can't handle it. Do you see what I'm saying? Like the decimal was 3.00038147, and your calculator can't put all of those decimals in that view. So it hasn't actually hit 3. It is an asymptote that we won't cross, but your calculator just struggles in showing that. All right, so let me go get all of this graphed in and let's rattle off some traits. I'm gonna draw the asymptote first. Okay, there is my horizontal asymptote. And there is my exponential function. All right, so let's get these traits figured out. All right, I've got no fractions, no radicals, no logs, domain, all real numbers, the entire x-axis. All right, my range. Oh, hold on. This is where you get to see your teacher is a little bit too anal retentive. I have an arrow here and I don't have one here. And yes, that bothers me and I'm okay with it. All right, going back to range. So for our range, we're starting at 3 and we're heading up to positive infinity. All right, and for our end behavior, if I take a look, it looks like I have a horizontal asymptote on the left and my right arrow is up. So I will write HA, Y equals 3. This was on the left. And then on the right, I had an arrow heading up. All right. And let me hit zoom 6 just to make sure that this matches what I have on my paper. And it does, right? I see that exponential growth and I see it's been shifted up 3 units. And if you wanted to check that out, you could write the line Y equals 3 in here. I usually like to make my asymptotes thick, so I scroll to the left of that equal sign and hit enter. So you can see I have that thick line. And there goes that boundary of Y equals 3. Okay? All right. So with that, we're going to move on and we're going to start stretching our graph vertically. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Bye.